हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून. माय नेम इज धार्मिका गोहिल. आई एम पर्सुइंग माय SYBA फ्रॉम एथिंस्टन कॉलेज. वी आर सेलिब्रेटिंग वाइल्ड लाइफ वीक स्टार्ट फ्रॉम टुडे एज ऑन 2nd अक्टूबर 2020 एंड इट विल एंड ऑन 8th अक्टूबर 2020. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द टॉपिक वाइल्ड लाइफ पार्क्स इन इंडिया. व्हाट डज इट मीन बाय वाइल्ड लाइफ पार्क्स? वाइल्ड लाइफ पार्क is an area, whether within a sanctuary or not. It can be notified by the state government to be constituted as a national park by reason of its ecological, faunal, floral, geomorphological or zoological importance needed to the purpose of protecting or developing wildlife therein or its environment. Human activities are prohibited inside the national parks except for the ones permitted by the chief wildlife warden of the state under the condition given in Chapter 4, Wildlife Protection Act 1972. In simple words, a wildlife park is a large area of natural land protected by the government because of its natural beauty, plants or animals. And any human activity is prohibited inside the national park. Now, let's see what does it mean by wildlife sanctuary. As the name suggests, wildlife sanctuary is the place that is reserved exclusively for the use of wildlife, which includes animals, reptiles, insects, birds, etc. It provides habitats, safe and healthy living conditions to the endangered and rare ones so that they can live peacefully for their life and maintain their viable population. Now, let's see what is the difference between wildlife national park and wildlife sanctuary. Wildlife parks is an area of land protected by the national government to conserve its entire ecosystem like its natural beauty along with the wildlife. Wildlife sanctuary is a natural protected habitat which provides protection and favorable living condition to wildlife, including the rare or endangered species of plants, animals, insects, etc. Wildlife parks protect the entire ecosystem, the land, plants, animal, landscapes, historic objects, etc. Whereas, wildlife sanctuaries mainly provide protection to birds, animals, insects, reptiles, and other organisms. Wildlife parks are highly restricted area. Human activities are not allowed in comparison to wildlife park. Wildlife sanctuary are not highly restricted area. Limited human activities are allowed in wildlife sanctuaries. Wildlife parks have clearly marked boundaries, whereas wildlife sanctuaries does not have visible or marked boundaries. Wildlife parks can be owned by the government only. And on the other hand, wildlife sanctuary can be owned by government or private organization. As you can see, our country is blessed with forests and natural wealth, which you can find in every state, every region. This map shows the various national parks in the country. You can pause the presentation and have a look on the map. As we go through the history of wildlife parks in India, there is the contribution of late Prime Minister of India, Indira Gandhiji. When Indira Gandhiji came to power in 1966, wildlife was in crisis. Post-independence, areas of prime forest had been cleared to settle partition refugees in the Terai and other regions. As a new India was born, natural habitats were destroyed to make way for mines, dams, real estate, infrastructure, and industrial projects. Wild animals were hunted ruthlessly. A sitting target for anyone with a gun and pursued harshly in vehicles until now inaccessible jungles. Tigers were prized trophy with big game hunting safaris organized for foreign tourists. Trade in tiger skin was unrestrained and unexposed by a forest officer, Kailash Sankhala, who was to lead Project Tiger along with a woman journalist, showed how snow leopard, tiger, leopard pelts were sold openly and in great number in bazaars. Indira Gandhi laid the foundation of much of legal and policy framework that protects India's forest and wild creatures. The first landmark was the first International Conservation Union that India hosted in 1969, where the crisis of the tiger was brought to the fore. What followed was an immediate ban on tiger shooting. Soon after, a task force was created to draft the Wildlife Protection Act. It was tested in Parliament in 1972. Facilitated the creation of wildlife sanctuaries and national parks, strictly restricted and regulated activities in them besides banning hunting of wildlife. India's first national park was established in 1936 as Haley National Park. Now it is known as Jim Corbett National Park. It is situated in Uttarakhand. By 1970, India only had 5 national parks. In 1972, India enacted the Wildlife Protection Act and Project Tiger to safeguard the habitats of conservation-reliant species. Corbett has the glory of being India's first, oldest, and prestigious national park. It is also being honored as the place where Project Tiger was first launched in 1973. Today's condition of wildlife in India. India is one of the 17 mega diversities in the world and is home to 7.6% mammals, 12.6% of birds, 6.2% reptiles, and 6.4% of flowering plant species. The country also has some of the most biodiverse region on the planet, and it comprises 4 of 35 biodiversity hotspots of the world, like the Western Ghats, Eastern Himalayas, Indo-Burma, and Nicobar Island. So far, country's wildlife is preserved in 100 plus national parks. India has approximately 2,714 endemic lichen species. In 2020, the lichen park was developed by the Uttarakhand Forest Department in Munsiyari. There are more than 100 national parks in India. As per the data realized by National Wildlife Database, as on December 2019, Wildlife Institute of India, Dehradun. It is not possible to read out all the names, but you can always pause the presentation and take a look on all this. These are the list of national parks located in Maharashtra. Chandoli National Park, which is located in Sangli district. Bhugamal National Park, which is located in Amravati district. Navegaon National Park, which is located in Gondia district. Panch National Park, which is located in Nagpur district. Sanjay Gandhi National Park is located in Mumbai district. Tadoba National Park is located in Chandrapur. There are around 36 sanctuaries in Maharashtra as per the Wildlife Institute of India, Dehradun. You can pause the presentation and have a look on this. why it is important to save wildlife in India. For healthy ecosystem. The ecosystem is all about relationships between different organisms connected through food chains. Even if a single wildlife species gets extinct from ecosystem, it may disturb the whole food chain. Therefore, for balanced and healthy ecosystem, saving wildlife is really important. For medicinal values, a huge number of plants and animal species are used to benefit humans in one way or the other. Many of the medicines have been derived from uncultivated plants. Not only plants, but many extracts from animal species are rich in nutrients and antioxidants. If wildlife is not preserved today, there would soon be a time when human race would also be in great danger. For healthy environment, wildlife also plays a significant role in keeping the environment clean and healthy. Many microorganisms, bacteria, earthworms feed on plant and animal waste, decomposing them and releasing their chemicals back into the soil, thus replenishing it with nutrients, which in turn are taken up by roots of plants, enabling them to grow and develop. Aesthetic value. Wildlife and nature obviously have an important role in impacting beautifully aesthetic to our planet. Forests, rivers, oceans, birds or animals all contributed in beautifying the earth in a major way. If there are no forests, rivers, animals or birds, earth would turn into a barren land with no traces of life. And last but not the least, animals also have equal rights as we humans have the right to live. So we should just help make this world a fairer place for all the animals. Thank you so much to everyone for giving your precious time to me and listening this whole presentation out. Thank you so much again. Thanks a lot.